Hello, today I am doing a Rabbie Burns dinner because although Burns night was last week, I forgot all about it and put myself down for a double shift at work and wasn't here for my Burns supper. And I love haggis. It is my favourite, absolute favourite. So I'm doing it this week because I'm not missing out. No way, Jose. So for those that don't know what is a Burns supper, it is haggis, neaps and tatties. What's neaps? Turn up. What's tatties?
Potatoes.
Potato.
What's tatties, tatties?
Potato, potato.
Tomato, tomato.
This is my sous chef today. What we've got going on. I'll need some salt.
You can do that, Tim.
No.
No? Just walk a bit, no?
No, I don't want
to. Why do I get a big whip on a chair? Look, it's like I'm breastfeeding. My baby. It's a breast milk.
Right.
So.
Okay. Anyway.
Salt for the tatties.
Okay, you want to put...
Two
heaped tablespoons of salt in your potatoes.
Come toys now, Scotch. It's a run point.
Tatties and
neeps.
One tablespoon in your neeps. Is that
all
your potatoes?
Yeah, I thought you
said that. Cover them, but just leave a little gap, tilted slightly
with
your lid, just to let some steam out. And I want to mash them, so I put it on for 40 minutes.
Cooking with Teresa. You've went from doing makeup to being like a full-blown chef.
No, I'm not a chef. This is just because I'm Scottish. So I absolutely love haggis. Like I said, it's my favourite. But when I was a little girl and I found out what haggis was, I didn't like it and wouldn't eat it for years. But honestly, it tastes like spicy mince. It's beautiful. And if anybody's a vegetarian out there, I have tasted vegetarian haggis and it is also delicious. Because it's so popular up here, even your Indian takeaways are doing haggis pakora, and it's gorgeous, and they do vegetarian haggis pakora. It is absolutely the best.
The bomb diggity.
The bomb. It is the bomb, and if you have it with a whiskey cream sauce, woo! Amazing. So, Steph, tell them, come in the camera. Steph, tell them what is haggis made of?
Haggis is the sheep's heart, liver, lungs, and stomach. Or encased in a sausage thing, casing thing. So you obviously do it with the mince up, sausage comes out. Haggis, you know, you've seen butchers there. The thing goes into like a...
Sausage skin.
Sausage skin, aye.
So this
certificate, responsible citizen, is what my oldest daughter got at assembly the other day there. She has no idea why she got it, and apparently they give these out all the time to people. It just reminds me of Arrested Development when maybe school grades them with like crocodiles and stuff like that. Well done, Hen. Proud of you. Anyway, what have we got here? Lots of some booze. Behind the margarine, some more booze. Booze on every shelf. Okay, we're actually wanting to make a whiskey cream sauce. I need double cream, some mustard, some whole grain mustard, and some whiskey.
So, making whiskey cream sauce, heating double cream, according to Henry Michaels, heating double cream, 2 teaspoons mustard, whole grain mustard, 1 tablespoon of Dijon mustard,
'bout the whiskey?
It just says combine it all, but I'm think I'm just going to heat this up a wee bit and then put the whiskey in. Okay. Maybe taste the whiskey a wee bit more.
Okay, what's next?
I'm going to put in two teaspoons.
So what whiskey have you went for?
This is Glenfiddich single malt, 15 years old.
It's good stuff. We don't drink whiskey. Steph's dad's a whiskey drinker. He's a Cooper,
that's
right. He's a Cooper.
It says 2.
Yeah, that's fine.
What would it be? 3
for good measure, always. But it's alcohol involved.
But I would walk 500 miles, and I would walk 500 more, just to be the man who walked 1,000 miles to fall down at your door.
Okay, I was going to address the haggis, because that's traditionally what you do before you eat it. You recite one of Rabbie Burns' poems to the address to the haggis, but it's far too much slang in it. I can't read it. It's really difficult. I even said to Steph, could he do it? And he can't do it. It's so hard. So I'll put the poem at the end and you can try it yourselves. Bye, guys.